Local police dogs got a special training today by the Department of Homeland Security. NBC2 Jacqueline Beavis attended today's training. New at 5:30, she is live outside JetBlue Park with a look at why these dogs have to keep up with the times.
Yeah, Peter, the Department of Homeland Security has never done a training quite like this. 2 days with canines from all over Southwest Florida. It's all part of an effort to make your next trip to JetBlue Park and other areas around Lee County and Southwest Florida a little bit safer.
I mean, these dogs do some amazing things.
Finding explosives, hiding in the open.
So it's not just a training aid, so when it's hidden, it will look like a real device.
And knowing the difference between what's real and what's fake.
Some of them will be empty, some will have what's called distractor odors, and some will have actual explosive odors in them.
The Department of Homeland Security is mixing the typical dog days of training with something new.
We match scientists and chemists that understand what these odors do and try and understand how we can present them, how we can discover more about them.
The science of the scent.
It gives us a better understanding of the odors that we train on and how things work.
Sergeant Fred Jenke and Blitz trained for the first time with the federal agency, keeping local law enforcement up to speed with ever-changing explosives.
We're proving out what their strengths are and where we may have potential vulnerabilities.
The demand is going up for the number of times we have to deploy them or use them for different events.
It's trainings like this and the reward of success that's keeping local law enforcement on their toes. Now, those local units will get a chance to see their data and learn from that. And then the Department of Homeland Security will also take that information to enhance their trainings for dogs here locally and other canines around the country. Reporting live in Lee County, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.